Welcome once again. Right now we're at Romans chapter 13, verses 1 through 7. Relationship with the government. Paul said, "Let every soul be in subjection to the higher authorities, for there is no authority except from God, and those who exist are ordained by God." Now, this is a question that a lot of people ask. Does God want us to submit ourselves to government officials that require us to do something against God's laws, against God's will? And the answer here, the short answer here, is absolutely not. What Paul is saying here is that you need to respect the office, the position of government, because the office itself, the position of government itself, is in place by God. The person or the people who are there, well, that's a different story. Those people can be completely wicked. And you know, the scripture says a lot of things about wicked governments. And no, you know, Moses did not bow down to Pharaoh. And you know, Jesus did not bow down to the authorities there either, because he knew what the will of God was. For those of you who have a problem with what I'm saying right now, I want you to take a moment and think. Just think of the most evil country in the world today. The most evil country. Think about it right now. What does that government do? What does that government say? What are the laws in that country? Is that what God wants those people to do that are in that country? Does God want those people who are living in that country to submit to that government? What you need to understand is there is a hierarchy of authority, okay? And of course, God is at the top, okay? If anything comes against God's laws, okay, I would advise you not to do it. Keep in mind here, the context here is a very general context in Romans chapter 13, verses 1 through 7. You're not to apply these principles in a very absolute, universal, all-inclusive sense, okay? There are many things throughout the scriptures that really speak in generalities. Most of the time, there's always an exception to the rule. Just don't make it the rule. Therefore, he who resists the authority withstands the ordinance of God, and those who withstand will receive to themselves judgment. For rulers are not a terror to the good work, but to the evil. Again, you got to think here as we're reading through this. In one country, something could be evil. In the other country, it could be well praised, okay? You got to really, really put your mind to this kind of stuff, because it's only applicable in a certain context, in a certain way, in a certain generic sense. Do you desire to have no fear of the authority? Do that which is good, and you will have praise from the authority. For he is a servant of God to you for good. But if you do that which is evil, be afraid. For he doesn't bear the sword in vain. For he is a servant of God, an avenger for wrath to him who does evil. Now today, we would say the sword is like the gun. The police officers, they don't bear the guns. They don't carry guns for nothing, okay? And with all this talk about evil, we need to define what evil is. You know, 1 John chapter 3, verse 4 says that sin is transgression of the law. And of course, in context, that's God's law. That's not just any old man's law that just makes up anything. Okay? That's not sin against God. But sin against God is sin against God's law, obviously. So evil is anything that's against God's law. Okay? When you disobey God, that's evil. Good is when you obey God. And how do we know what God's law is? Well, once again, we read it in the scriptures. It's all right here. Therefore, you need to be in subjection, not only because of the wrath, but also for conscience's sake. For this reason, you also pay taxes. For they are servants of God's service, continually doing this very thing. Therefore, give everyone what you owe. If you owe taxes, pay taxes. If customs, then customs. If respect, then respect. If honor, then honor. And in the midst of our studying this passage, let's not forget, Paul is talking to those believers who live in Rome at his time. He's not talking to those people or the believers that live in the most evil country now in the world. He's not talking to people today who live in countries that are very corrupt. Let's not lose sight of the context here. We've got Paul, approximately 2,000 years ago, writing to his fellow believers in Rome. And once again, seek God with all your heart. And if you do, you will find him. Call upon him, and he will show you great and mighty things. I love you guys.